What's up everybody, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. We will see today on the difference between the house lords and the tenants. Okay, what do you mean by a planet placed in a certain house? Okay, we will see that today. And before I begin, if you have not subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you have any questions, queries or comments on my earlier videos, then please let me know in the comment section. Okay. And if you do not know what is the tagline of this channel, then let me tell you, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. Yes. So, today the video is very important. This is one of the most important videos in this series because you have to understand this video properly. Maybe you have to watch it 2-3 times, because when I learned this part, it was very difficult for me to understand with my little fund of intelligence. Okay, so I don't know how much time you will need, but no problem, we can keep seeing videos again and again in YouTube. That's the best part, right? Okay, so today what I'm going to discuss is, which is very important, what is the meaning of a planet placed in a certain house? Okay, there's a lot of confusion sometimes which happens. That, for example, if suppose Sun is sitting in the first house, what will it do? Okay, if suppose Sun is sitting in the ninth house, what will it do? Okay, there's a lot of confusion here. There is not confusion on the area of Sun's impact in the ninth house, but the confusion is what exactly Sun is doing. Is it doing only that, or is it doing something else also? So today we will see that. So as in my earlier video, I showed you house lord and house tenant. Okay, lord means a sign which is placed in a particular house, and that house will be ruled by the ruler of that sign. Okay, so for example, somebody is an Aries ascendant, his first house is ruled by Mars because the sign Aries is in his first house. So for an Aries ascendant, again, if you don't know what's ascendant, then you will not understand this. Please go back to my earlier videos and watch it. Okay, so similarly for a Libra ascendant, who is the ruler of the first house? It is Venus, because the sign Libra, number 7, is falling in the first house. That means Libra is ruled by Venus. So the first house is having the dynamics of Libra. That means the first house will be ruled by Venus, the planet of love and creativity, etc. So what I mean to say here is, if Venus sits in the fifth house, okay, in anybody's horoscope, depending on the houses it is ruling for that particular ascendant. Okay, so for example, if Venus is sitting in the fifth house in the sign of Aquarius for a Libra ascendant, it will have a different meaning than Venus sitting in the fifth house in the sign of Sagittarius, okay, for a Leo ascendant, because for Leo ascendant, Sagittarius will fall in the fifth house. Okay, so, and it will also have a different meaning for a Cancer ascendant with Venus placed in the fifth house in the sign of Scorpio. Yes, because for a Cancer ascendant, number 5 will be Scorpio. Okay, the fifth house will have the number 8, which is Scorpio. So that's what I'm trying to say. Just blindly we cannot make a dictum. Okay, my Venus is in the 10th house, I will have many women at my workplace. It does not mean that. It means that, but what kind of woman? Suppose you are a Libra ascendant, then the sign in your 10th house is Cancer. And suppose your Venus is placed in the 10th house, in the sign of Cancer, then you can meet women who are like Cancer. What is Cancer? Cancer is the sign of mother. Okay, motherly figures. That is different from a Venus in Libra. Okay. For example, suppose you are a Capricorn ascendant. Then for a Capricorn ascendant, the sign in the 10th house is Libra. So suppose your Venus is sitting in the 10th house in Libra. Okay, in its Mool Trikon Rashi, very powerful, then it means that you, the kind of women you will meet in your workplace will be very young, okay, and they will be very much talkative and they will like to communicate very much, okay. They will be very much outgoing, they will be very much flamboyant, or if it is in Gemini, then these traits will be more, okay. If they are in Aquarius, okay, then the kind of women you meet will be different. They will be very much philosophical and very much unorthodox, okay. So, you see there, just because you have Venus in the 9th house, it does not mean that you will meet women when you go to long distance travel, okay. Or if you have Venus in the 3rd house, it does not mean that you will meet women when you go in a short distance travel always. Suppose Sagittarius is the sign which is in your 3rd house, you are a Libra ascendant. So for Libra ascendant, 1st house is number 7, 2nd house is number 8. 3rd house is number 9. So Sagittarius is in the 3rd house. So suppose you have Venus placed in the 3rd house for a Libra ascendant, then what does it mean? You will meet lots of women, or you can meet your spouse when you go on a short distance travel. But what kind of short distance travel? It is religious travel, because it is the sign of Sagittarius. Do you understand now? Yes, that's how you have to read it. Don't just blindly say that, oh, you will meet ladies or you will meet your spouse when you are doing short distance travel. But the person may do short distance travel every day for his work, for his health problems, or for any reasons. Okay. So what does it mean? Yes. So we have to see the sign. Sagittarius is religious, the sign of religiosity and spirituality, etc. Same is with the sign of Pisces. Okay. So that is how you read the chart, you start reading the chart, that's how. So, what I wanted to say in this video is, you have to know what the planet is doing and what it is representing in the chart. That is very important to know, okay. If you do not know what the planet is representing in the chart, how will you know what it will do? And how will you know what it is representing? Just see which houses it is ruling, okay. It's very simple. For example, if you are Aries ascendant, which houses does Saturn rule in your chart? The sign of Capricorn is in the 10th house. The sign of Aquarius is in the 11th house. That means Saturn is ruling your 10th house and 11th house. Okay. So, Saturn's rulership, what is the meaning of rulership of planets? Rulership basically means resources. Okay. Rulership means resources. Rulership means resources. What inherently the planet has. See, that is the home of the planet. Okay. The signs which it is ruling, it is the home of the planet. So, what do I have? Only what I have in my home. That's what is my resource, right? And suppose now I'm sitting somewhere. For example, suppose Saturn for an Aries ascendant, ruling the 10th house and the 11th house, is sitting in the 9th house. In the sign of Sagittarius, okay, because for Aries ascendant, 9th house is having the sign Sagittarius. So now, how would you interpret this? That Saturn, who is ruling the 10th house and the 11th house, is sitting in the 9th house, okay. So that means Saturn, although he is sitting in the 9th house, but he is telling that I don't belong to this house. My home is in the 10th house and the 11th house. So how would you interpret this? This simply means that Saturn sitting in the 9th house will have linkage with the 10th house and the 11th house. Basically, to be very precise and simple, it simply means that if Saturn ruling the 10th and the 11th is sitting in the 9th house, it means that the agendas of the 10th house and 11th house. See, the agenda is the rulership. Agenda has to be very clear. Saturn is trying to fulfill the agenda of the 10th house and the 11th house through the house where it is sitting. Okay. Don't just say, okay, Saturn will give results of 9, 10, 11. Don't just say like that. Okay. Primarily, its agenda is 10th house and 11th house. Okay. But how will it fulfill that agenda? How? It has to be somewhere, right? So it is sitting in the 9th house of spirituality. That means 10th Lord is sitting in the 9th house. Okay. That means his name, fame, status in life okay, can come from dealing in areas related to religion, spirituality or law. So this can, people can make great lawyers, okay. And 11th house is what? Money, network circle, gains, okay, large organizations. That lot is also Saturn, which is sitting in the 9th house. So what it means basically, that Saturn is telling, my agenda is to gain network circle. 10th house also and 11th house also, because Saturn rules two signs simultaneously. 10 is Capricorn, 11 is Aquarius. So apart from the career and status, the things of the 11th house which Saturn is ruling, it is telling, I will try to fulfill those agendas through the 9th house. You understand? Yes. So Saturn, for an Aries ascendant, if it is sitting in the 9th house, it will try to fulfill the agendas of the 10th house and the 11th house through the 9th house. So that means whenever the person will do some religious activity, okay, now 9th house can have different meanings, but for Aries ascendant, 9th house also has the sign of Sagittarius, and Sagittarius represents core spirituality, okay. So in this case, if the person does spiritual activities, okay, he can get a lot of name fame, and he can get tremendous money and tremendous network circle, because Saturn is ruling the 10th house and the 11th house, okay. So that means the agendas of the 10th and the 11th will be fulfilled through the 9th house. See, it's very simple. Suppose you go to somebody's house and you see somebody sitting there, okay. Or suppose you are sitting in your house and somebody knocks the door, ting tong, and you open, there's a person who has come to your house, and then he tells you that, oh, I want to sit in your house, okay. It is like the planet itself, not the rulership, okay. So the planet is coming and sitting in your house, okay. Suppose you are the 9th house, as I said, okay. So now Saturn is sitting in the 9th house. So it will tell, see sir, I am sitting in your house, but my agenda is not to sit here. My agenda is to fulfill my original purpose through this house. It's like a person who comes to your house and asks, give me some sugar, give me some milk, or give me some rice, or give me something to eat, okay, or just sign this bill, I just need this sign. So he has come to your house with an agenda, okay. Agenda is not that house. Agenda is the house which is ruling, okay. So suppose you are a Libra ascendant, for example. Which houses does Saturn rule for a Libra ascendant? Capricorn and Aquarius will fall in the 4th house and in the 5th house. If you count 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 10, 11 is 4th house and 5th house. So now suppose here Saturn is sitting in the 10th house. Okay. In the sign of Cancer for a Libra ascendant. Ruling the 4th house, 5th house. Okay. So then Saturn is telling, I will bring property matters 4th house to my 10th, to the 10th house. I will bring education matters to the 10th house. 5th house is education. Okay. So this means that if Saturn is in the 10th house for a Libra ascendant, this simply means that the person can do very good in property business or in real estate, or even as a teacher also. Or he can do very good in opening new ventures of education. Okay, because 5th house is also the house of teaching, and it's the house of gaining knowledge actually. 9th house is the teaching guru, and 5th house is the shishya, disciple, okay. So this is how you have to study placement of the planets, okay. So remember, agenda is to fulfill their lordship. So for example, if somebody's 7th house has a planet, okay, suppose the ruler of the 6th house, okay, is sitting in the 7th house, okay. Let me give you an example. Suppose you are a Aries ascendant, okay. Who is the planet which is ruling your 6th house? Mercury, because Virgo is falling in the 6th house. Yes, Virgo is number 6. So suppose Mercury is sitting in your 7th house, okay. What is 7th house? 7th house is the house of marriage. For Aries ascendant, 7th house is ruled by Venus, because Libra falls in the 7th house. So now what is happening is, Mercury, who is ruling the 3rd house and the 6th house, because in 3rd house there is the sign of Gemini, okay, is sitting in the 7th house in Libra, okay. So what it means? It simply means that the 6th house of disputes, quarrels, trials, tribulations, war. Third house is also the house of war, actually. Many people don't know, but third house is actually the house of war. So the planet whose agenda is to give you war is sitting in the seventh house of marriage. So what happens? As soon as you marry, you may have difficulties in life. Yes? That's one example. And another example is, suppose somebody is 10th lord. 10th lord is the planet which shows your primary karma in this life. Okay? What you will end up doing? 10th lord is sitting in the third house. Okay? Third house is what? Communication, journalism, short distance travel, writing is the third house. Okay? So suppose you are a Libra ascendant. Who is your 10th lord? Numbers 4 is in your 10th house. Cancer. So moon is the 10th lord. So suppose moon is sitting in the third house in Sagittarius. So what it means? Agenda of moon is to give you rise in status by sitting in the third house of communication in the sign of Sagittarius. So these people, if somebody is has some Libra ascendant has his moon in the third house, these people can become excellent preachers of spirituality, because the planet moon is the 10th lord of primary karma. He is sitting in the third house, in the house of communication. But what kind of communication? For Libra ascendant, third house is having the sign of Sagittarius. So Sagittarius is the divine sound, okay, the mool trikon sign of Jupiter. So it means that this person can do very good in areas of advising and counseling through spiritual domains, okay. Through spirituality, he can help uplift people, okay. So these are the examples. So always remember, agenda is the lordship, okay, and the placement shows how it will fulfill the agenda, okay. Suppose 7th lord of marriage is sitting in the 10th house, okay. For a Capricorn ascendant, 7th lord is moon. Suppose moon is sitting in Libra in the 10th house, okay. That means what? As soon as you go to work, as soon as you get a job, you may find your spouse and you may get married. Because the moon who is sitting in the 10th house is telling, moment you activate me, I will bring my conditions apply list. And what's there in the conditions of moon? That I will fulfill the agenda of the 7th house, because I am ruling that house. That is my house. Yes, I may be anywhere. I may be in the disco dancing with a girl, I may be in the temple praying God like this, or I may be in a hotel eating tofu. But where do I belong ultimately? I belong to my home ultimately. Yes, so lordship is like that. Yes, lordship means where I belong to and what's my agenda, my inner self, my inner belief, my inner desire actually. Okay, so this is what I wanted to say, and if you have any questions, queries and comments, then please let me know in the comment section. This is a bit difficult to understand, but you guys are smart, you might have already understood, but I needed some time to understand, so I am saying that you might need some time to understand. No problem, if you have some doubts, you can watch this video 2-3 times, okay, and you can take a note, a pen and a paper, and you can write down. As I said, Saturn for a Libra ascendant sitting in the 10th house, what it will do? It will bring 4th house and 5th house matters to the 10th house. That means land, property, hotel, real estate, education, creativity, etc. 4th house and 5th house matters. Okay. And I already said, for a Capricorn ascendant, moon in the 10th house, what it does. Okay. So that's what I wanted to say. Don't just blindly say, oh, I have moon in the 10th house, this will happen. No. You have to see which houses moon is ruling and which sign is moon placed in, okay? Because moon in the 10th house will have different meanings for all the 12 different ascendants, okay? So, from tomorrow, I will start this video on this series on ascendants, on different ascendants, what every planet does, okay? Because that's very important to understand. Otherwise, we will not be able to give a proper prediction, or we will not be able to understand what actually it means when we say that there is this planet which is placed here, okay. Well, the question is what that planet is and which houses it is ruling, okay, and also what are the natural traits of that planet. For example, if somebody's Venus is in the 10th house, irrespective of the sign, irrespective of whichever lagna it is, you can say that he will have many females surrounding him in his workplace. Okay, now it depends on the sign. As I said earlier, if it is Cancer, it will be motherly figures, okay? Or your boss may be a woman, your boss may be a lady, no? She can look like your mother. So, that's how you understand. Or if it is in Libra, they will be very young. If Gemini, they will be extremely talkative, yes? So, that's how you have to understand. You have to go into very much detail and in particular, you have to analyze meticulously. You cannot just give a blind eye for eye. Okay, you have Venus in the 10th, I have Venus in the 5th, this will happen, that will happen, okay? So, that's it from my side. If you have any questions, queries and comments, then please let me know. And before ending, again, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will be there. And if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, then what you are waiting for? Please subscribe to it and share this video with your family, friends, relatives and spread the divine knowledge of astrology. And if you have not watched the earlier videos, please watch, because now things are going to get heavy. Otherwise, you will feel like, oh, what's going on here? I understand you might have felt when you are seeing this video, right? But there's no problem. We can again watch it and you can watch the series. Okay? So that's it from my side. Bye-bye. See you.